Hello, Jake Raby here, coming to you from the Morgue at Flat 6 Innovations.
Here we have the engine from an 02996 C4S. This engine experienced a noise that sounded like a lifter. This is a common thing that we hear when people have a noise in the engine. It is oftentimes misdiagnosed as a lifter. We actually were able to walk through some diagnostics on the phone with this customer, grab some information about some other things with the engine, what the oil consumption was, if there was any misfires, anything like that. And we determined, like hundreds of other engines we've seen, that this was not a lifter that was failing. It was confusingly similar to a lifter noise, but what would have had occurred was a cylinder had failed. Now, what I'm showing you here is piston number 6. So this is bank 2 of a 36996 engine. Bank 1 would be down there. Bank 2 is up here. And this is cylinders 4, 5, and 6, okay? These issues of cylinder bore scoring occur more on bank 2. This is bank 2 of this engine. So this is oftentimes misdiagnosed as a lifter because it has the same rhythmic tone, the same volume, and the noise seems to come from the same part of the engine. Now the reason why it does that is because the piston, the iron coating that's on the side of the piston from the factory that creates a dissimilar wear surface from the aluminum lock-a-seal cylinder will actually start to flake off, okay? And when that happens, it increases the cylinder clearance between the piston and the cylinder, and you end up with this wear. So you can see here, this is the bore that goes along with that particular piston, okay? Now, what I want you to pay more attention to is what we're actually seeing here is collateral damage. This is secondary damage. The bore scoring was not the primary failure. Again, I'm gonna say this cylinder that you're seeing here did not fail first. This failed as a result of the skirt coating that was originally on this piston flaking off. Now, this is a prime example of a in-process failure on two other cylinders. If you look closely, this is piston number 4, the one you see here. You see how it's got the nice patch of dissimilar wear coating there? It's already starting to come loose a little bit, starting to flake off, as you can see. But it's not come off completely. Now, if we look at that particular cylinder, that cylinder looks fine. It's got a little bit of wear on it that would be considered normal, but you can see that it has not worn through the first layer of the cylinder material like this particular one has, okay? So what we're seeing here is this failure of the cylinder is a secondary failure. It actually occurs because the piston loses the skirt coating. That is our primary mode of failure. So now we're gonna go to cylinder number 5. I'm trying to focus in here. Cylinder 5 is also starting to lose its coating. And these pieces, this is ferromagnetic, and I can actually catch a fingernail on this. A lot of times we find this in the engine's oil supply. Okay, so as you can see, this is starting to come off this piston, but it has not come off completely. Now, the purpose of this is to create a dissimilar wear surface so the aluminum piston does not ride directly on an aluminum cylinder. When the skirt coating comes off, that wear surface is compromised. Now you can see, since the skirt coating looks worse on that one, the cylinder is starting to wear. It is not worn completely yet, but it is starting to wear. Look at the bottom, okay? This is where we see this failure occur at in the very beginning, is at the very bottom where the skirt of the piston actually travels, okay? So, with these two failures, this would be considered a stage 1 failure for the cylinder and pistons. This would be considered a stage 2, okay? This one is considered a stage 4 because here we've skipped the whole stage and now we've actually got all the wear coating off the skirt of the piston and we've seen extensive cylinder bore scoring. So this is the cylinder that was ticking like a lifter. The reason for that is because when this piston travels to bottom dead center, it has to go through changeover. Changeover means it will rock one direction, and then when the piston changes direction to come back and travel up the cylinder wall again, it will rotate and it will rock, and that's changeover. So changeover is the rocking. So when you hear that tick, 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 you're hearing this piston go tick, 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 tick. That's what you're hearing. That's what's fooling an untrained and even sometimes a trained ear. Now, on this side, we're looking at the opposite side. Because of the amount of piston offset that is machined into these pistons from the factory, this side of all the pistons looks really good. Even the one that's worn the most on the top has not began to flake off its cylinder, its piston skirt coating yet, okay? I'm trying to get a better picture of this for you. But this doesn't look bad at all, okay? So what we can see here is most of the wear is really focused on the top of the piston, toward the top of the engine. And that's what exacerbates that sound of tick, 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 tick more than anything. So if you have been told by others, even professionals in this world, dealership technicians or whoever may be, that you have a lifter failing, that is probably not the case. We've only seen maybe 5 lifter failures in all the years we work with these engines. 95% of the time, you're dealing with a cylinder failure, and do not let it fool you. Send the car on over to Flat 6, and we'll take care of it.